Can you imagine the 80s classic movie Ferris Bueller's Day Off without the characters driving around in the iconic convertible? The 1961 Ferrari GT serves as a centerpiece of the film. However, in the initial drafts of the script, director John Hughes had a different car in mind. A Mercedes-Benz 450 SEL 6.9. Yes, the trio could have been driving around Chicago in this car. Thankfully, Hughes later saw the convertible in a magazine and made the change. The convertible was in peak cool in the 1980s. But in the recent decade, sales have been declining. Convertibles now account for less than 1% of new car purchases. Their popularity has been up and down since its introduction. But this time, the convertible might have a steeper hill to climb back up. So why is the demand for the once classic car running out of gas? In the beginning, all cars came without a top. German inventor Carl Benz developed the gas-powered vehicle in 1885, and it wasn't until 1910 when the first closed vehicle was manufactured. But the first technical convertible with a retractable hardtop was designed in 1922 by Ben P. Ellerbeck. However, Ellerbeck's concept was never put into production. In 1927, convertible cars were officially introduced to the market by several manufacturers, but these early models were poorly constructed. The roofs let in cold drafts and were insecure. The tops had to be manually retracted. But in 1934, these operational issues were resolved when a dentist with a passion for car design invented the first power retractable hardtop. Georges Apollon patented the design and it debuted on Peugeot's 601 Eclipse. The roof was electrically powered and it folded back into the trunk. In the 1940s, Chrysler and Ford introduced their own convertibles into the market. But despite these advances in technology, the roofs still weren't perfect. They were still quite loud in drive. Because of this, the convertible fell out of fashion in the United States. In World War II, American soldiers in France and England observed people driving around carefree in their soft-top sports cars. When they returned to the U.S., convertible sales skyrocketed. Soon enough, every car manufacturer offered a convertible in their lineup. There were a total of 33 models available. Sales grew by 6% throughout the 1960s. But by the next decade, the market hit another wall. This was largely attributed to the invention of air conditioning in cars.
And such design features as the sunroof, made with you and the way you live clearly in mind.
Sunroofs were also introduced. In response, many automakers dropped them from their lineups. While advancements in cars attributed to the decline of the convertible in the 70s, there were rumors that federal regulation rollover rules would put an end to their production altogether. Supposedly, the standards were going to require all cars to have stronger roof structures that would protect drivers from being crushed in rollover accidents. But being that convertibles didn't even have roofs, it was thought that it would be illegal to produce them. So the 1976 Cadillac Eldorado was advertised as the last convertible in America. Drivers were eager to get their hands behind the wheels. The company produced 14,000 of them, which was a steep increase from the 8,950 made the year before. It became an instant collectible as people believed the value of the car would increase in the future. For a brief moment, this belief held true as used versions of the Eldorado sold for many times its worth throughout the 1970s. But the convertible didn't disappear from roads for long. Rollover regulations weren't as harsh as anticipated, and convertibles were exempted from the new regulations.
Our Chrysler LeBaron series, nobody has anything like them.
In 1982, Chrysler produced the LeBaron convertible. It was the first convertible car model made since the 1976 Eldorados. The LeBaron had front-wheel drive with the K-car platform, which was a first for Chrysler. This design made the vehicle 800 pounds lighter and 2 feet shorter than the previous model. This allowed the convertible to be more affordable and practical than ever before. The convertible was no longer just a car for only the wealthy. Throughout the next couple of decades, convertible car sales held steady and several iconic models from automakers rolled off assembly lines. With improvements in interior designs and additions of high-tech features, the performance of convertibles became better than ever. Automakers were able to produce ones that appealed to both high-end and low-end consumers. The market hit an all-time high in 2004, and convertible sales reached a record level with 831,000 units sold worldwide. Sales remained high for the following few years, but in 2008, the auto market essentially crashed during the Great Recession. Car sales across the board dropped, and new vehicle sales fell by nearly 40%. Convertible cars took an especially hard hit. From 2011 to 2015, sales dropped by 7%, even as the auto industry was getting back on track. In 2014, just one decade after the market peaked, sales hit an all-time low, with only 164,000 convertibles sold in the U.S. The style has reached a new low. But unlike previous temporary deaths, we can't attribute the dip to the addition of sunroofs or air conditioning. The main reason for the current decline is due to the rise of the sports utility vehicle. SUVs are now the best-selling type of car, with 29.7 million sold globally in 2018. Sales have more than doubled since 2010, even as the auto industry has declined. People prefer the SUV over the convertible for a number of reasons. For one, SUV performance has improved throughout the years. In the 1990s, most SUV engines only offered horsepower ranging in the hundreds. Nowadays, most engines have numbers in the 300s, and some even reach over 500, such as the Range Rover Sport SVR at 575 horsepower and the Jeep Grand Cherokee Trackhawk at 707 horsepower. Drivers no longer have to sacrifice performance anymore by choosing an SUV over a convertible. But SUVs are not completely immune to the unpredictable market. Although growth is continuous, acceleration has slowed and is predicted to soon reach stability. In previous years, the United States led sales in the automotive industry. But in 2010, China overtook the number one spot in the global sales market. This has continued to hold true, with China having sold 28.08 million cars in 2018, while North American sales were behind with 20.86 million. The market is now driven by Chinese car trends, and its citizens are opting for SUVs. Only 24,000 convertibles were sold at the Chinese market's peak in 2012. High pollution levels in the major cities pose a major threat to the air quality. Consumers with the means of affording a convertible live within these cities, but are not buying them because of the poor air quality. Korean companies like Kia and Hyundai haven't officially produced a convertible since the Kia Elan in the late 1990s. This is because smog drifts over into the country from China, so drivers often have to have their windows up. Finally, the once sporty look of the convertible car is disappearing. With less convertible options, many designs are smaller and no longer fall under that "I'm having my midlife crisis" appearance anymore. You see more box-shaped convertibles like the Fiat 500 or the Mini Cooper now. Most convertibles are only offered in the high-end vehicles like the Mustang or Corvette. So although the convertible car seems as if it's reached the end of its road, analysts agree that the car will never completely sputter out. Past trends show the demand is cyclical. According to a survey from Hertz Corporation of 574 consumers, results showed if convertibles became more affordable, had more room, and were quieter, they might buy them. This may sound like the complete opposite of how we normally picture a typical convertible, but the trend could arise again in the fashion of a convertible SUV. These provide the wanted benefits of owning an SUV while giving drivers that desired wind-in-your-hair effect like a classic convertible. What other popular items or trends have fallen from grace? Tell us in the comments below. While you're already here, be sure to like and subscribe to the channel. And go ahead and click on that notification bell to be the first to know when we post new videos.